fresh laid concrete, melodies blowing. Don't care where we're going, but the day is wasting. Just keep moving and take it all in. The rumble of voices, the beats to a song, the horns are just on the beat, honking along. Let's be the harmony.
Changchun is the capital city of Jilin province, located in northeast China, with the province comprising of 7 districts, 1 county and 2 county level cities. From the 2010 census of China, Changchun had a total population of 7.5 million. The name of the city means long suffering in Chinese. Known locally as the city of automobiles, Changchun is an important industrial base with a particular focus on the automotive sector, also known as the Detroit of China. Changchun has a four-season humid continental climate. Winters are long, lasting from November to March, cold, windy, but dry, with the January mean temperature of minus 14 degrees Celsius with moderate snowfall. Spring and fall are short transitional periods with some precipitation but are usually dry and windy. Summers are hot and humid, having concentrated rainfall with July averaging at 23 degrees Celsius. In this video, we will have four of our hosts who will share their experiences and advice regarding life in Changchun. Jilin University, located in Changchun, founded in 1946, is a leading national research university. It's a Chinese Ministry of Education class A double first class university. It's constantly ranked as one of the most prestigious universities in China. The university has 7 campuses, home to 43 colleges covering 13 academic disciplines, from which our focus will be medicine, that's acknowledged by the WHO.
Studying at JLU is quite a challenge sometimes. One of the pros is that they provide you with all the facilities you need. It's all there. However, sometimes I personally feel that the teachers could improve on the delivery of content during the lecture classes. So that's one thing I would like to talk about.
Most of the knowledge that you're going to gain here is going to be by your own effort. There will be lectures in the class, obviously, but the teachers will only give you the main points to work with. Later on, you have to expand by yourself, get your own resources, get your own books, and build from there.
Alright, so in terms of studying in the city, there are various universities other than Jilin University, which we are based at. There are more language-specific courses, engineering students, aviation college, and so on and so on. So there's a whole lot of array of students and courses that one can do in the city.
As a local person, I think study at a Chinese university, I can enjoy our university's facilities and also can meet some foreign students. And this make my life is very cool, and I think make our life is also very cool.
In terms of studying, life on campus, I think it's really nice. The facilities, the way they've decorated the campus really can help motivate your study and liven up your study experience here. Going around the campus, going to classes, coming from classes, seeing the nice scenery, the lakes, the shops, all kinds of facilities. It's really helpful.
For me, the campus is a place where I go to if I want to have a walk, if I want to go do some sports in the stadium, if I want to chill out with friends, we can go to the mall that is here inside the campus as well. So there are many places that you would want to visit here if you're on campus.
In terms of life on campus, as in at Jilin University, I can only say that there are so many things to do. It all depends on the actual person, how much you actually want to explore your pace. If you want to chill here or outside, but provided that you keep it in the campus setting, you will find everything from eating out to chilling, it's all there.
Well, my favorite one in campus is the shopping mall, because we can do like watching a movie in the mall, sometimes we can eat in the mall, or we can do sports or like swimming or make a exercise in the gym. I really like that one.
In terms of study and campus facilities, the university really provides everything you need medically wise. I mean, there are two whole campuses we study medicine on, the Ximin campus and the South campus. The Ximin campus has all the hospitals and the lab classes, the anatomy building, and they really have all the latest tech that you need.
After the lectures in the class, I feel like the lecture wasn't enough, or maybe it's lacking some information that I want to know. So I'd like to spend my time after that in the Dingxing library, because it's quiet and it's really big and nice, and it gives you the study environment.
In terms of the campus's facilities, as I was saying previously, it's got everything. It's a different question whether us foreign students can actually fully exploit it. But the libraries are fully set up. The classrooms can be also up to standards. In general, it depends. It could do with some improvements, but the truth is, you're here to study, just get it done.
Other than the shopping mall, there are some other things as well, such as there is a library you can study 24/7, or you can do some sports in the sports center, and there are some parks with a lake you can relax doing something you like.
The study environment here can be quite a challenge. To be honest, it is a challenge for many students here, simply because the overall morale is not as you expect it to be. Many students just don't study very well or don't put the hours or efforts in, and very few do. So if you're one of those that really want to study and make the most of it, you really got to push yourself and motivate yourself. You can't expect other students or your teachers to really push you.
In terms of the campus, it's changed so much since the very days we came here. At the time it was all right, but now I have to say there are some really beautiful spots, from the flower garden, the artificial lake, we've got our very own shopping center. It's pretty cool. It does feel like a mini city within an even bigger setting.
I really enjoy being in Jilin University campus, and it's very spacious, it's very relaxing, you can do a lot of things in it.
Whilst in China, do make sure to download the popular free social media app named QQ, known as the Facebook social media platform of China. Not only you can stay in contact with your friends, you can translate the message you receive from almost any language into English. A very useful app, especially in terms of file sharing up to a moderate size of 2 GB across many media platforms.
In terms of shopping experience, I am more of a tech guy, so I really like to go to Bainohui. Bainohui has not only clothes and textiles, but they also have all the latest technology. Computer parts, computer series, wires, you know, hardware, software, it's all there.
Shopping here isn't really efficient sometimes, because you mostly just find Chinese brands, and I personally like foreign brands because they're more my taste, so it's kind of hard to find what you want sometimes.
I personally am not a big shopper, but the truth is it's nice to have a bit of everything in the city. With all the shopping centers and foreign stores, you really can get pretty much everything that you need. If not, there's always the online platform. So the truth is there's nothing that we could possibly not put our hands on.
In Changchun now, you can shopping in different places, and there are more and more shopping malls. And in each shopping mall, actually you can buy multiple things. And for the prices, sometimes for the local things like made in China is slightly cheaper than some other products which come from outside China.
In terms of favorite shopping place, again, Bainohui is number one in terms of tech and hardware. However, if I want to go buy some clothes, I can go there too, but most of the time, since it's closer to here, I go to Oya Mai Chang. They have all the H&M, Bershka, Zara, all the, you know, Western brands.
One of my favorite shopping places here is Oya Mai Chang. It's a really big mall. It has specifically some foreign brands, like the ones we have back home, so it's really fun to go there and find what you actually like.
My favorite shopping place, that has to be the New Life Shopping Center, which is also one of the newest ones in the city. It's just awesome, but also the surrounding. It's got restaurants, bars, a roof garden. So again, I'm more excited about the place itself rather than the shopping experience.
So for me, my favorite shopping mall is like New Life, because it's near the another shopping mall which is called Oh Yeah. So these two, you can buy some higher products and you can also buy some normal things. So this is the thing I like to do in I have to say in Guilinlu area. If you come to here, you can go to Guilinlu area and near to Nanhu Park, you can find those shopping malls.
In terms of prices and foreign products, there's many here. You can get pretty much anything you need. However, it will cost extra more simply because the foreign products are deemed more prestigious, so they put the extra price tag on it. So don't let them haggle you too much more.
When coming to Oyamaichuan, you'll find some foreign brands like Zara and Bershka, and the prices there, they're standard prices. They're not super expensive, but they're not like super cheap either. They're just standard.
Again, at the time of my arrival, there were limited foreign products, but the truth is, over the past couple of years, it's become gradually better and better. These days, you can get everything, and in terms of their prices, they are relatively reasonable. There's nothing too expensive. I would say, in general, today, as a foreign person, you can really get by here quite comfortably.
One of the unique things to do and find at Bainohui is that one of the buildings has a whole floor of just a photo shoot. You can go then have a personal photo shoot with all kinds of backgrounds and 3D structures. It's amazing, it's really nice.
On my day off here, I like to go to Oyamaichuan and go to the ice rink at the bottom floor. It's really big and it's really cool to just skate around in the weekend.
So as I was saying, my favorite place is definitely the New Life Mall. It's got so many different kind of things. The shopping part, as I said, I'm not so much excited about, but it's all about what's outside with the cool restaurants, western bars, roof garden. It's all there. Really, I really like that place.
Another highly recommended mobile app called WeChat is the most popular messenger app in China. This app allows you to do more than to have conversations and post moments. You can order food, movie tickets, taxis, flights and railway tickets with another extremely useful application of having an online WeChat wallet linked to your bank account, using the app itself as your electronic bank card almost anywhere all over China.
In terms of leisure time, my favorite pastime is often I have a very busy schedule and I get quite exhausted throughout the week. So at the end of the week, I often go to the spa at Kyushu, which is opposite Walmart at Northgate. It's an amazing place to really just relax and, you know, let yourself go.
In my free time, after I finish my studies, I like to go to Happy Land. They have a brand new cinema there. It's really big, it's clean, it's super modern, and you can watch all the movies that you want.
In terms of how I spend my free time, I do a lot of sports, and in Changchun it's no different. Most of the times I gather with some of my friends and play football, whether it's the foreign community or my Chinese team, whether it's in the evening time or sometimes with the Chinese, especially at the weekend. It's all about getting together, having a good game, and then kicking it from there.
My leisure time, I like to go to the city center called Guilinlu with my friends and my classmates.
It's always good to go with somebody or a group of friends. It's always great. But if you just want to go on your own, it's also fine. But it does get quiet. In terms of pros and cons, the food there can be very expensive. And the prices to go in, it's cheaper to buy online on the Meituan app, as around 65 RMB, as opposed to going on paying at the counter, which can be like 100. So make sure you want to buy it online, the ticket, before you go.
When you come to buy a cinema ticket, don't buy it from the box office, because the tickets are going to be much, much more expensive. So you can buy them through the WeChat app.
The cool thing about passing time here is that there are actually things to do. Again, a lot more than before. It's not all sports related. The truth is that you're hanging out with your friends in a bar or going for food, checking into some sort of cinema experience is extremely affordable, and they are all over the place, so it's not a very difficult thing to find one near your place.
We like to have coffee first and to just relax there and talk. And later, for our Chinese people, we really like to go to karaoke. We call it KTV.
I think it's a place of interest because it's right next to the campus, just opposite Walmart. On top of that, you can hold gatherings and parties and birthday parties and have a really great time there. And, I mean, it's a nice place to just chill out.
This cinema is one of the best cinemas here because it's close to the campus. You don't have to go so far from like your study area. And you can spend time, and even if the movie ends late, you won't have to get back to your dorm room or apartment late.
The truth is that back in Europe, I wasn't really a big fan of going to shopping malls. I find them lame, but here, there's a completely different cultural element to it. So anybody who's interested in doing virtually anything, I would much rather send them to any of these major shopping centers, because everything can be found within the same building under the same roof. I wouldn't say that there are unique things as such, or perhaps I'm just not the one who's doing them, but in general there are many super super cool things, and I like to spend my time with my friends, so everything would be related to them, whether it's going out for a cool place as in an eating experience, or having a couple of drinks, traveling together. It's always going to be something to do with my mates, which means it's not only affordable, but having the time to do it is also something that's really cool as opposed to being in Europe.
And then one of the KTV I would like to recommend is the KTV. You can book it online, and it's in Lehuoli. So it's very reasonable price, and you can do it online, which is very convenient. Basically, you just don't need to talk with the service people, and you can enjoy this environment. It's modern, it's convenient. You can book the songs with your phone, and all the functions you can just do it without actually talking to the person. So we enjoy this, and we being like modern. That's very cool. I like it.
One of the unique things to do there is that you can get personal massages, you know. But, you know, of course, it's professional. However, it's just something that I just don't feel comfortable with.
When you're here on a 6 years program, it's really easy to get bored. So I would suggest you to get a hobby to do in your free time. Like, for example, you can try the VR machine, the virtual reality one, in any mall. There are so many.
This is the app named Meituan. A very useful app that allows you to order and buy almost anything you can think of. Food, movie tickets, and travel tickets. They often hold many discounts for many things that may be of interest to the user. Do make sure to keep a lookout for special offers during your stay in China.
Changchun as a whole has quite a history. I mean, during the World War II, the Japanese invaded this region of China, is where they began. So they set up a lot of bases here. And you will see many buildings here that are very, you know, inspired from the Japanese architecture. So a lot of the buildings, for example, the first hospital, I mean, it has a whole wing that's just based on Japanese architecture.
If you want to know more about the history of the city, you can go to the Dingshan Museum, which is next to the Dingshan Library in the campus, so you don't have to go so far like other historical places around here.
Changchun and the northeastern part of China in general has a pretty extensive history, and all of those people who are interested could visit one of the many available museums, could even watch some movies or read some books. So anybody who is interested in such topics would find this place just perfect for added information. But there are many things to do in terms of finding out a bit more about Changchun and this area before, more recently, and then now.
Well, there are three things I would like to say. The first movie actually is made by here, and the first car also made by here, and the trains, the parts also made by here, so there are some culture things you can visit.
In terms of history again, with the local people, they're not very fond of the Japanese, simply because some of the, you know, atrocities that they did. I don't know if you already know, but during the World War II, the Japanese took a lot of prisoners and did a lot of raw scientific experiments on them. And, you know, and to be honest, in the modern day, modern medicine, it became the father of medicine. There's a lot of data that came out from that study?
About those places, actually you can make a tour to each of the places where I just said, and you can see the movie, how they make it, you can see the facilities again, and also you can make the tour to those places where you can make the you can see how to make the car or how to make the train. You can ask them questions.
Traveling in China during rush hours, winter seasons, or simply if you are interested to travel in comfort around the city, Didi app is what you need. It allows you to privately hire a taxi, just like Uber drivers known in the West. It's fast and convenient, just enter your destination address and confirm.
In terms of food and what to expect here, well, it's China. Chinese food. But it's gonna be a little bit different from the Chinese food you've had back at home. Chinese food here is more the authentic, you know, like that. Chinese food. But of course, don't be disheartened that there's gonna be no foreign food. There is. There's Western food, there's Russian food, there's Indian food, Pakistani food, European food. So you gotta find the right places to find them.
China and its people in general are massive when it comes to food, which is a good thing for me. But in Changchun, it's no different. There is virtually everything and anything that you can find, and there are certain places in the city which cater for everybody's needs in general. So this is definitely a good place for a foodie person.
Wow, actually in China, there are 8 types of food. And where I'm from, Northeast China, we call it Jicai, like Jilin province dishes. And we specifically like to eat everything, like put it together, and then we make it like our dish. And this kind of restaurant, you actually can find it everywhere, and the price is very nice.
In terms of favorite food place, well, I don't really have one. However, if I was to say, to tell you where I do go to eat most of my meals, if I were to go eat outside, it's probably Grandpa's Kitchen at Northgate. They have all the foreign food you need. It's pretty good. I like the quality. It's nice. Prices are decent as well. They're not so expensive and not so cheap. It's affordable.
My personal favorite food is definitely the German Beer Street and a particular restaurant called the Bockstube. The reason why I like to go there is obviously because of the type of food that they serve. It's quite close to what I was used to back before I came to Changchun. General, but also the general environment, the people, and the pricing. It just all does it for me. They also have a nice outdoor area, so when it's good weather, it's just easy to go there.
Also, my favorite restaurant called is the restaurant with it Dongfang Rouguan, and they have the typical Chinese food, I mean local food. You can taste it, called Guobao Rou. It just made it one dish. I just love it.
In terms of cooking, well, I cook a lot. Recently, I haven't been able to due to internship, but when I do cook a lot. In terms of that, I cook a lot of meat, so I have to go find halal meat for myself. And that's no problem. There's no problem in finding halal meat. It's everywhere. The prices is affordable.
While it's extremely convenient and affordable to eat out, I am personally a big fan of home cooked food. So it's something that I enjoy doing and I like to do quite often. This also means that I need to get all these ingredients from somewhere. As I was mentioning it before, Changchun is very good at catering for everybody's needs. And most of the apartments come with well-facilitated kitchens and so on and so on. So it's not a difficult thing to get by. You shouldn't stay hungry.
However, if you want to make your own food, that's no problem, because there are some shops you can get your own ingredients. And 2 places you can go, one is called City Shop, and the other one is a super big supermarket called Metro. So you can get almost all the ingredients there, and you can make your own food.
In terms of foreign cuisines, well, you will find the European cuisine, you can find Russian cuisine, Chinese, of course, Japanese, Korean, Indian, Pakistani, and these are the main cuisines that I find that is very, you know, open to the public here, especially for farmers.
Some other things I would like to say, we eat all kinds of food, and we have different national food as well, such as Japanese food, German food, Indian food, Korean food, and we also like hot pot. because here in winter it's quite cold and we enjoy this. And the atmosphere is also very good. We can have it run together, we talk, we eat. We really enjoy this kind of moment.
My favorite place for social time, well, there's a few, you know, there's not one specific favorite place. Like I said, would be the spa, or maybe on a campus site somewhere, maybe in a rich indoor mall, or maybe to the malls that are outside. And I like to eat desserts. I like desserts. I like the fine desserts.
For social lifetime, you go to Guilinlu. There is many shops there. You can shop for clothes, you can shop for food, you can buy ice cream. There are many ice cream shops there. And if you go down the road, there's also a zoo. So it's all within a hand's reach.
Changchun's nightlife and how one may go about socializing. I have to say that the city again is getting much better. There is a very healthy crowd of both foreign and local people who seem to have the same interest. There are plenty of places to go to. If you happen to be the clubbing time with the banging music, this is the place for you. If you like quieter lounge bars, again, with the newer additions to the city's nightlife scene, you will be happy. If you like pubs and the even quieter experiences, you've got a bit of everything.
I like to social a lot, and Changchun, today's life is a big difference as before. So my friends and I decided to go to places. We can go to cocktail bars and clubs, and sometimes we can go to sauna house. But most of the time we like to go to like a bar or a club, which we can see different people, how they enjoy their life. And we can also meet some foreign people, we can to know different culture, and we can make some friends. These kind of things is very very good and interesting to do, and the price again is very affordable.
You can expect anyone at these places. You can expect foreigners, Chinese, you can expect students, non-students from other universities, anyone, you know. These are open places. The campus is open to the public too. I mean, you might find a random lady. I mean, how are you, you know?
When you come to Guilinlu, you will see many Chinese people, especially at the night time on a Sunday. Any weekend, basically, you will also see a lot of foreigners because there are some foreign restaurants here, like an Indian restaurant. So expect to see a lot of foreigners.
Advice on social life, I would say that try and do your best to make friends with everyone, you know, get to know everyone. Don't shut out people just because you don't see eye to eye on certain things. You're gonna be living here 6 years. You need to have friends, you need to have people to go out with, and you never know when you might need someone's help.
Over here, there's not much time to have a social life. You can have after you finish all the tons of study that you have to do. But you can have some friends time, one-on-one in the weekends maybe, every once in a while, but definitely not in exam time.
The only bit of advice that I'd like to give to especially the newcomers is to be adventurous. Go out there, don't just sit around your home settings, but really go out and see who's about, what is there to discover. As I said, there are plenty of places to go to, many people who would have similar interests, and there is absolutely no reason for you not to make friends shortly after your arrival.
If you're coming here, I'd suggest you to have a balance. Try to have a balance between your studies and your social time, because it's really easy to get distracted from studies and just keep on partying the whole time, but that's really not how medical school works. So just try to have a balance between the two.
Thank our hosts for sharing their experiences and advice. We hope this was to your satisfaction and helps you to decide if Changchun and Jilin University is the place for you. We have given an overall introduction to the city and university life here, but not to make the decision for you. We wish this video can help you understand and pursue what your life could be like here. Please check our other videos on YouTube for more information. My name is Wakil. It was a pleasure to narrate and guide you through the documentary. Please share, comment, and subscribe. Thank you.